you're looking to buy or sell an account or get your badges grinded, make sure you hit up Goat Plugged. The link will be in the description. You will now regret their services. I think we can all agree that we were all excited for NBA 2K20 as soon as we found out that the original park rep system was coming back along with the pie charts, because it gave us a whole new aspect of creating our players. As of now, in most of the community's opinion, the game is completely dead, and I'm about to explain why that is. So I have a list right here, and I'm gonna go over everything on this list. But I'm just gonna start off with the main problem, in my opinion, why this game seems dead. And this, in my opinion, is the biggest problem in the game. And you guys have to understand, this is all my opinion. Everybody is entitled to their own opinion, and I want to know what you guys think in the comments, so please let me know. I will gladly respond to the comments. This is a very important subject, considering this is what I do for a living. Everything I do is related to 2K, and I want this game to be the best it could possibly be. First things first, I'm gonna say this blunt. 2K20 is 2K19 with a gameplay patch and rep. Tell me I'm not wrong there. Tell me that I'm wrong, because it's 2K19 with a gameplay patch and a rep system, bro. It's exactly the same thing. Everything else is the same except the gameplay, and they've added a rep system, which is so sad in my opinion. It's like they didn't even care. It's like they just said, we're gonna make the new game, we're gonna keep everything, we're just gonna change the gameplay around and then add a rep system and expect the players to be happy. No, that is not true. This game is boring, bro. It sucks. I want it to be good. This video isn't to bash 2K. It's to make the game better. This game is boring, bro. It feels like I'm playing 2K19 still every day. When you're playing with the same visuals, it feels so repetitive and redundant, bro. It sucks because it honestly feels like we are playing NBA 2K19. I want to know what you guys think. They copy and pasted the whole neighborhood exactly, pretty much. Like, and not the fact that they even lied about it, which made it way worse. I'd rather them just be honest instead of lying, bro. Like, it's just so sad. Pie charts. We thought that we were going to have more freedom while creating our player. That is actually the opposite. We are way, way more limited with these pie charts. In my opinion, last year we had way more freedom when creating our players. Now we are completely capped into, I believe, 8 or 10 pie charts. And they promised custom pie charts. We all know that did not happen. There is really only a few builds you can make. In reality, you can only make as many builds as there are pie charts. Yes, you can change the title, the name of the build, but in reality, it's still the same pie chart. The shooting in this game is actually good. I like the shooting, but a player with a 73 should not be able to green every single shot just because they know how to time their shot perfectly. Yes, you could say that increases the skill gap, but it ruins it at the same time. Because let's be honest, timing your jump shots, not that hard. I want the game where if you make an inside center, you shouldn't be able to shoot. A 73 point should go in, 70% of the time with perfect shot timing, not 100% of the time with perfect shot timing. Because even in real life, top shooting players don't make every single shot. Stephen Curry misses wide open shots. And in the game, he has a 99 three-pointer. New content. A lot of people say that the content is good. They added new events. I guess you could say that, but the problem with the events is they're delayed every time. And people cheat and boost to win. The events are half-ass. The events are cool when they're completely legit and there's no cheating, no different servers. If the events were completely legit with nothing else involved, the events would be great, and that would really add a great aspect to NBA 2K20. Another thing is the clothes. They recycled the Christmas clothes from last year, and didn't it say like Christmas 2018 or something like that ridiculous. Like, I feel like 2K as a company has to try harder. Think about Fortnite. Think about how they're always changing stuff around. 2K, when it comes to a patch, it takes them like months. I really don't understand that. They say that they have to get approved by the console, but why does Fortnite or these other games fix stuff within a week, or if not a week, within a few days? I really don't understand that. Console lag. Why does a PS4 Pro work perfect in the park, but a normal PS4 does not, or a PS4 Slim has lag or latency problems? Why do I have to spend $400 on a PS4 Pro just to play the game properly? That, as a company, is a disgrace. 2K, if you're watching this, please fix that, because that is very sad. People cannot afford the PS4 Pro or the Xbox One X. If they have the base Xbox from 8 years ago, they should be able to play. You guys have to make it compatible for that, or have an update for each specific console, even if it requires lowering the graphic quality, but so they can have at least smooth gameplay. Because, you know, you're a billion-dollar company. Have some smooth gameplay on all of the consoles. Skill gap. There hasn't been a skill gap in a while in any 2K. 2K16 was the last one with a skill gap. Now, creating a skill gap is hard. I don't know how to do it. I'm not going to sit here and make up a lie or story on how to increase the skill gap. Because I personally don't know. But there needs to be a skill gap. There is no reason the game should even be close when I know I am 100 times better than a person. For example, my win percentage is like an 88 or something. There is no reason that the game should be close with a person that has a 20% win percentage when I'm trying my hardest and the game just lets them do stuff. Or, you know, I don't know. I don't really want to get into the skill gap because I'm not too sure on what they can do to fix that. The layup consistency is weird, as you guys saw in the beginning. The inside shooting is broken. In real life, if I am 5 inches taller than somebody and I'm shooting a wide open layup, it doesn't even matter about the height. If I'm shooting a wide open layup and I'm in the NBA, I should not miss. Let's just be honest here. What NBA player misses a wide open layup? Yes, it happens like 3 times a year and it's all over ESPN, but come on now. Once a month, I probably miss, actually not, once like every 2 weeks, I'll probably have a teammate or I'm playing someone or me who will miss a wide open layup. That should just not be in the game. The last thing is animations. Why are we playing a game that is run through animations? The game is animation based. Yes, the game and other games have animations as well, but it shouldn't be animation based. It should be physics based. What I mean by that is, there's no way a guard should contest a 300 pound center's shot. I'm a 6'7 guard that weighs 180 pounds. I can contest a freaking 7'3, 300 pound center in the paint. I can't guard, like shut them down, but I can make them miss. If I think about that. I in real life weigh 200 pounds. That's like me saying I can't body a guy who weighs 80 pounds. Even if he's the same height as me, I am bodying a guy who I have 120 pound weight advantage over. It's not logic based, it's animation based, which is stupid. Yes, logic and physic based gameplay is more expensive, but you guys can afford it. That's all I got for you guys. Hopefully 2K watches this video. Like the video so it, you know, can get out there. Comment all you want. Follow me on everything. Hope you guys have a great day. Go out.